What's up, y'all? DJ Harrison.
This is Tennishu.
From Butcher Brown.
And we got caught shoplifting.
Red-handed.
So this record, Chet Baker Sings, is one of my favorite records.
I look at you and suddenly...
I found this record when I was like learning how to play jazz and going through jazz school. And so the songs on here really helped me to understand like what the magic of jazz is, to really hear it from someone who can sing and play in this way at that time, you know. It was cool, so I had to get this record, one of my favorites.
It's funny because I saw that they had this catalog. So you have, obviously, there's this. Talk about nostalgia, you know, like, it's funny because Peanuts was one of the first cartoons that I watched as a kid where I was really connected with the music, and I was like, oh man, this is kind of hip. You know, even as a kid, you kind of had that ear. It's like, I'm like, who's writing the music? And I found out it was Vince Guaraldi Trio, so. And when I had this on CD when I was in high school, and it's been since retired from all the scratches, and. So finding this here was definitely, I had to pick it up as soon as I saw it. But then also it led me to this, which I've never heard before. So now I get to like do some further research on the man Vince Guaraldi.
This record, Soul Train, John Coltrane. It's just one of those records that I listened to a lot in school, and I had to have it on vinyl. It's got You Say You Care on it, and I Want to Talk About You, which is one of my favorites. There's a video on YouTube of Elvin playing that tune with sticks, so it's kind of crazy to see a ballad played with sticks in that way.
Yeah,
so I had to get this one.
Junior Wells. I've never heard this record. I've heard some, I've got some Junior Wells compilations and a couple of different CDs in my collection. And it just, you know, getting back to the blues, you know.
Yeah.
Killer harmonica play. First time I saw him, he had a cameo in the Blues Brothers 2000 movie, like towards the end or whatever. Mm-hmm. And then I started like kind of digging into his catalog and just kind of like got reacquainted with the blues and everything.
You got the curls up top.
Right? The swagger, you know. It's gonna kill you right here.
You're helping me up and letting me down. Baby. So I got Miles Davis, the quintet cooking, you know what I'm saying? I got this because this has one of my favorite versions of Tune Up on it. But I love that tune, and so I had to pick up this copy of Cooking with Miles Davis Quintet. Bam.
You gotta indulge for a second. Classic. It's a classic record. You just kind of have to have certain records like this in your at your disposal. Right. Yeah.
Just the way those records sound.
Yeah.
They're like really like it. Like makes me think of lots of brass and gold.
Yeah.
And just like lots of like really like grandiose stuff.
Right.
Sonny Rollins, Saxophone Colossus. This again is another record that I just grew up on as a horn player. And as a jazz musician, jazz lover, most played out tune,
St. Thomas.
A lot of people play it, but I still think this is one of the baddest saxophone solos. Period. Like it's still, Sonny Rollins is insane. Strode Road too. The solo breaks at the end. It's insane. So I had to get this record on vinyl. Saxophone Colossus, Sonny Rollins, boom.
My man Bill. Man Bill Evans.
That's such a dope album cover.
Right, yeah. I used to have this album when I was in college, but I never had the vinyl version of it. I think this one was like Scott LaFaro. Scott LaFaro passed when he was like real young, right?
I think so.
Yeah. So it's like one of the only records, I guess, that they got to release with him on it. That, and I think the Vanguard, that was like his last gig.
Yeah, that trio was nuts.
Yeah. You know, just something smooth, something to set the mood. You know.
Got this Merle Haggard record. I am what I am.
I am what I am.
So the reason why I got this is because my grandmother, she used to live in Roanoke. We lived in Pennsylvania, so it was like an 8-hour drive back and forth. So I would ride with her sometimes, and she always listened to Merle Haggard, Kenny Rogers, all the like country hit makers. And so I was like, I gotta get this so, you know, maybe with my older ears, I could see what she saw. So we gonna see.
So how long are we in here? How long are we gonna be held captive over the shoplifting thing?
We should go back and get some more.
Yeah, I'm saying.
We got these bags.
I'm gonna need another bag.
We have more space.